Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-R, Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for the TEAS. We have been solving math problems out of this book here, the ATI TEAS Study Manual, the 6th edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. Today is our lesson number 132. We are on page number 81. Please turn to it. Make sure the book is in front of you. Turn to page 81. At the very bottom of the page, you will see 3 practice problems. Those practice problems is what we are doing right now. We are in the process of solving number 2. We did number 1 yesterday. Problem number 2 of 3. These problems deal with the concept of expressions, equations, and inequalities. Here's problem number 2 on the blackboard written out for you. It says, Tom saves $18.50 per week. Tom saves $18.50 per week. Let's see how the problem is written in the book. I'm going to read it to you verbatim. It says, Tom is saving money to go to a concert. From his part-time job, he is able to save. Okay, so it goes on. I'm going to start again. Tom is saving money to go to concert. They go on to say, from his part-time job, he's able to save $18.50 per week. His older brother gave him $25 to start with. His older brother was kind enough to say, look, here's the $25 to start your process. After that, the remainder, you're going to save yourself from your job. So he has $25 to start with. It says, how many weeks will it take until Tom has saved up $235? Apparently, that's what he needs, $235 to attend this concert that he wants to watch so badly. He's going to start saving money for it, and he's going to put aside $18.50 every week. Keeping in mind that he has $25 already, his older brother, his older sibling, gave him $25. He says, here's the $25 as a gift for me. Go enjoy your concert. That's all I can do for you. The rest is up to you. So let's see how he represents that. How do we represent the inequality that expresses this idea? This whole notion that we see here can be expressed in the form of an inequality, in a very elegant inequality. Algebra is elegant. Algebra is beautiful. It is very powerful. It expresses ideas and notions very succinctly, very powerfully. If one knows how to write and one knows how to read it, it's a language. You just simply have to learn the language. It is a language, just like any other language. Algebra is a language. Enough of the talk, let's begin. Here's our solution. At the end of the first week, and it's always a good idea to start out like this in a babyish manner, with the baby steps. But that way you know that you're going on the right track. That way you know that when you finally arrive at the expression, it'll be correct. There is no need to rush. How much money will he have at the end of the first week? He will have $25 that his brother gave to him, that he already has, plus the $18.50 that he saved that first week. $18.50 that he saved that week. How much money does he have at the end of second week, do you suppose? Well, at the end of second week, he will have, again, the $25 that he started out with, plus 2 times 1850. Because remember, at the end of the first week, he saved $18.50. At the end of the second week, he will have saved another $18.50. So he will have $25 that he began with, plus $18.50 times 2. This 2 that you see there is the number of weeks. That represents the number of weeks. Here also, if you wanted to, you could have put down 1 here. That represents the number of weeks that he has been collecting. At the end of the third week, he will have the $25 that he started out with, plus $18.50 times 3. Voila! And the process continues. We don't know how many weeks the process is going to continue. That's the whole point. The question is, how many weeks does he need to do this, repeat this process? For how many weeks does he need to save $18.50 before he has saved up at least $235? That is the minimum that he needs. Perhaps $235 is the price of the ticket itself. Maybe he wants a few more dollars just for spending money, but he wants minimum. He wants at least $235, and he wants to know, for how many weeks must I save $18.50 for my part-time job? Well, at the end of the first week, he has $25 that he started out with plus $18.50. At the end of the second week, he has the $25 that he began with plus $18.50 times 2. At the end of the third week, he has $25 that he began with plus $18.50 times 3. That's the amount that he has been saving for 3 weeks. At the end of W weeks, that's our unknown. We're defining our unknown with the letter W. Now, if you wanted to say at the end of X weeks, would have been just fine, would have been perfectly fine if you want to call your unknown X, or N for that matter, N for the number of weeks, N as an NC. It's perfectly fine. You can use any symbols that you want to represent your unknown. You can use X, N, W, hippos, monkey, bananas, anything that you want to use to represent your unknown is perfectly fine. But logic dictates that you must represent your unknown with something that is easier to remember. We're talking about number of weeks, so I find W easier. You understand? So at the end of W weeks, how much money will he have? He will have $25 that he began with plus $18.50 times W. Voila, that's how much money he will have. That's the amount of money he will have. That's the expression that we're looking for. Now, we are told that this amount of money that we'll have at the end of W weeks, which we'll find out how much W is in a second, even though the book does not actually ask us to solve for W, but we'll find out anyway. This amount of money that he will have at the end of W weeks, we are told, it has to be at least $235. Let's pick it up on the top. So this amount of money that I will have, if I keep saving $18.50 every week, given the fact that I had $25 to begin with, at the end of W weeks, I'll have my $25 that I started out with, plus $18.50 times the number of weeks I've been saving. And if I want that amount to be at least $235, which means this amount has to be greater than or equal to $235. That's the at least part. At least part that tells me that if it's equal to, that's perfectly fine. If that amount has to be exactly $235, that's okay, because they're telling us at least $235. It's either more than $235 or it is exactly equal to $235, it's fine. And we write it like this. This amount has to be greater than or equal to $235. Let's continue. Watch these videos in sequence. Because I don't have a luxury of repeating the same concept and same steps over and over again, for two reasons. First of all, it will end up taking an inordinate amount of time, and secondly, it will bore the pants off you, and we want to do neither. Do you understand? It will end up taking an inordinate amount of time, and if you're curious as to what that word means, we have learned it in our vocabulary lessons. In the event that if you happen to be one of those people who is interested in improving his or her vocabulary, it doesn't hurt to have a decent vocabulary. When you open your mouth, when you're trying to express some ideas and notions, having a little bit of a grown-up vocabulary always helps, instead of speaking like a child. Inordinate. I know we learned it. I'm trying to figure out which day. Day number 72. Very simple, just type in vocabulary words, day 72, along with my name, Keshwani, the video will pop right up. Watch that video where we learn inordinate, which means excessive, unreasonable amount of time. It means excessive, unreasonable. If I started explaining every single tiny step in excruciating details, every single video, it will end up taking excessive amount of time, it will end up taking inordinate amount of time, it will end up taking unreasonable amount of time. So we won't do it. So in the previous video, yesterday, we explained that this quantity that you see here can be written as 1850 times W. It can also be written as 1850 W. These are three different ways of saying the same exact thing, which is what we explained in yesterday's video. As I said, you watch, make sure you watch these videos in proper sequence. Also, if you want to get if you want to improve your math skill even more, you will find that we have solved all the math problems that appeared in the previous edition as well, the fifth edition. And you will find the solution to every single problem that appeared in the fifth edition from day number 1 through 80. TEAS, day 1 through 80, just type in TEAS day 1, and you will find the very first problem that appeared in this fifth edition. If you were to type in TEAS day 101, you will go to the sixth edition. There are no videos from 81 through 100, do not exist. In addition to that, there is a basic math series which will help you improve your skill even more. Back to our work here. Why are there so many different ways of saying the same thing? We can say, in other words, I can say, for example, I can say A times B, or I can say A times B, or I can say A times B, or I can say A times B. What the hell? Why are there so many different ways of saying the same thing? It's very annoying. Well, actually, it is not. As I said before, it is a language. Algebra is a language. Now I'm getting into a long digression, a long lecture here, but that's okay. Algebra is a language, and just like any other language, there are always more than one way of expressing an idea, a notion, a concept. For example, you might say that my uncle passed away. My uncle is deceased. My uncle has gone to meet the Lord. Or if you want to be very affectionate, you might even express your idea as simply saying, my uncle finally kicked the bucket. Well, that's the same ideas. Why do we have so many different ways of saying the same thing? Well, the same exact logic applies here. It's a language. They all mean the same thing. Don't freak out just because, oh, here's another way. Here's another way you could have put it. If you want to be silly, you can keep on going. Here's another way, which is also A times B. A times B. A times B. A times B. So this parenthesis that you see here, don't freak out about it. It's there just for the convenience, so you can see for the eyes of this times that, but it's not required here. So most of the time, it is simply written as 1850 times W, like that. And which is what you will find in your answer choices in the exam. Let's see how the book says. Yes, you see it says 1850 times W. It's written like this. Except they put down this 25 later, that's okay. This plus that or this plus that's the same thing. Enough of the talk, let's solve for W. The book does not ask us to solve for W. Book does not ask us to solve this unknown quantity, how many weeks actually it takes. Book is simply asking us to come up with the right inequality, which we have done. We're gonna solve for this unknown just for the hell of it, just for learning purposes, shall we? Let's do it very quickly. So here we have a positive 25, we want to get rid of it. Let's subtract 25 from both sides. Watch what happens. If we subtract 25 from both sides, what we find here is that we have a positive 25 and a negative 25. They kill each other. 1850W is going to come down. 1850W is going to come down. And 235 minus 25 is 210. And that has to be greater than or equal to 210. Divide both sides by 1850. 1850 is going to cancel out, and we find that number of weeks that he has to sell has to be greater than or equal to this quantity, 210 divided by 1850. And if you do that on the calculator, you will find, well, actually, I don't know if I want to continue with this thing. Just do it on the calculator. I'm going to do it with you. Comes out 11.35, which means he has to save for at least 12 weeks. It has to be more than this amount, which means he has to save for at least 12 weeks. I keep looking at my notes here because what I did right now, I don't like it. I hate using the calculator. I'm going to actually do it out exactly the way I wanted to do it out. Watch what happens, okay? Learn. Watch what happens. It's going to take some time, but this is just for learning purposes. Let's watch what happens here. So this is the quantity we're dealing with. Watch. 210 over 1850. What I want to do first is to get rid of this decimal from the bottom. We get rid of the decimal from the bottom by multiplying top and bottom by 100. And when we do that, on the bottom we'll end up with 210 times 100, just like it says here. And in the bottom we'll end up with 1850 times 100 will simply become 1850. Are you with me so far? I'm just going to pick up speed a little bit. If you divide top and bottom by zero, this is going to cancel out. And this is what we're left with. I'm going to do it on the top. Just to show you that it can be done without a calculator. You do not need a calculator. I don't expect you to do this in the exam. Do you understand? This is just for the hell of it. So here we have 21 times 100 over 185. 185. 1 plus 8. 1 plus 8 is 9. 9 plus 5 is 14. 14 is not divisible by 3. If the sum of the digits is divisible by, why don't we divide first top and bottom by 5? I was trying to see if this quantity is divisible by 3 because 21 is divisible by 3. But the way we figure out if a quantity, if a number is divisible by 3, is if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, then the quantity itself is divisible by 3. And you will learn that in the basic math series there. It's not divisible by 3 because 8 plus 1 is 9, 9 plus 5 is 14, and 14 is not divisible by 3. But I just realized, why don't we divide by 5 first? Let's divide top and bottom by 5. How many 5 does 1 have? 1 has no 5. 1 has no 5. That one goes and joins a 0 and becomes a 10. And 10 has 2 5s. And how many 5 does 0 have? 0 has no 5s. In other words, 100 divided by 5 is 20. Let's do the same thing at the bottom. How many 5 does 1 have? Well, 1 has no 5s. 1 is too puny to have any 5s. What happens to that 1? That 1 goes and joins the 8 and becomes 18. 18 has 3 5s. 3 5s are 15. After we take away the 15 from the 8, we have a remainder of 3. 3 goes and joins the 5 and becomes 35. Or 35, rather. 35 has 7 5s. 35 has 7 5s. 7 5s are 35. So what are we on the top? We end up with 21. 21 times 20. 21 times 2 is 42. 21 times 2 would have been 42, you see. 21 times 2 is 42. And then we have a 0 at the bottom. That's 20. And at the bottom we have 37. Watch what happens. I'm going to wrap it up very quickly. Watch what happens. 37 times 10 is 370. That's too small. We have 420 on the top. Let's add one more 37 to it. If we add one more 37 to it, we get 704. And this quantity represents 37 times 11. But that's still too small. We have 420 on the top. There you go, which is why we need 12 weeks. Because if we add another 37, we end up with 14. Four. There you go. This quantity represents... There you go. He wanted to have minimum of 235 weeks, and that's going to happen when he says for 12 weeks, because this quantity is more than 11, as you can see, because 11 times 37 is only 407. We have 420, which means this 420 divided by 37 is more than 11. He must save for more than 11 weeks. Let's find out how much money he will have if he actually saves 12 weeks. If he actually saves 12 weeks. Remember, he's saving 1850 per week, and we want to save for 12 weeks. Okay, let's do it together, shall we? We're going to worry about the decimal at the very end. 2 times 0 is 0. 2 times 5 is 10, 0, carry 1. 2 times 8 is 8, 2 is 16, plus 1 is 17. 2 times 1 is 2. Hold the unit digit, 1 times 0 is 0, 1 times 5 is 5, 8, and a 1. 0, 0, 7 plus 5 is 12, 2, carry 1, 10 plus 1 is 11, 1, carry 1, we get 21200. And now we can go and put our decimal that we had to begin with, which is right here, which means you will have 1200, which means you will have $212 of savings in the course of 12 weeks. That's not enough. He wanted 230 some dollars, didn't he? He wanted $235. So why is he stopping at the end of 12 weeks? Don't forget, he had $25 of gift from his brother. He had gotten $25 to begin with from his brother. Voila. When you account for that $25, now he has $237 and he wanted a minimum of $235. There you go. If he saves for 12 weeks, he'll be all set. If he saves for 12 weeks, he'll be all set. Something has gone wrong here when I did 420 divided by 37. 420 divided by 37. It is more than 11. But as you can see, if he saves for 12 weeks, he'll be all fine. He'll be all set. He will have more than enough money. He will have more than enough money because he wanted $235. We did a lot of extra work in this problem. None of that was required. All they wanted was inequality, which we arrived at long time ago. All of this was just for fun. And of course, that is the right thing to do because we are here, after all, to have fun. Bye now.